busy talking about Clinton and these tapes that we forgot to mention that this is Country Music Week. The mm-hmm. CMA Awards air on Wednesday, so a lot of big stuff going on. Very big star here with us today. Shall I just read a few of the things going on right now?
Oh, go ahead.
The single you just heard, Forever Love, top 10 right now.
Keep going.
Stars in a movie on CBS this Sunday by the same title, Forever
right.
Love.
Go ahead.
Has her own star now on the Hollywood Walk of Fame that she mm-hmm. just got. Has a hot tour with Brooks and Dunn.
Right.
Is performing this Wednesday on mm-hmm. the CMA Awards. And is up for vocal collaboration with Brooks and Dunn.
And,
shall I go on?
And just got out of the Redhead boot camp backstage.
Oh.
Here is Reba McEntire.
I'm totally wrong.
She's wearing black.
Yeah, no. You're supposed to dress like Lori Ann. Everybody else has to.
Blew my theory all to thunder.
How you been?
I've been fine. How you been?
Nice to see you.
That's my
color.
How are you, color. How are you doing?
I'm good.
Good to see you.
Are you wearing black mascara too?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, man.
I said, well, that's wrong. Okay, that's wrong. You know, but really, if I was going to come out here and look natural, like she said that you wear that because you look, I would have bounced out of bed and just come just like that. Natural. And you wouldn't have wanted to see me, I promise you, not
you,
at all.
No, it'd be a real cold day when you showed up like that here, you know.
I think you look great in black. In
yeah.
fact, look at this. This mm-hmm. is an Anne Klein, the new fall fashions. And look, this is such a shocker, looking inside. Reba's in it. You're
ooh.
A model now.
Where, no, I'm not. There I am.
Yeah. Yeah. So how do you get to be a model for Anne Klein?
They called and asked me if I wanted to do it, and I said, who else is going to be there? And they told me, and I'm a big fan of BB's, and
mm-hmm.
I know Ann Richards, the governor of Texas.
Right.
See, these are all real women.
Yeah, they're all very mm-hmm. professional. We had models and Olympic gold medalist, mm-hmm. and it was just really exciting.
And you're
I got
all
to
together.
Meet most
you're all
of
together
them.
Right there, right?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
There was 2 or 3 days of filming. Like Ann Richards wasn't there the day I was there.
Olympian,
she
district
was,
attorney,
she was.
CEO, and president of a company, singer Reba.
Yeah, when you get such a different group of people there, as far as careers and everything else, what do you talk about? What do you guys talk about?
Well, we really didn't have much time to talk.
No,
just
really?
As soon as I got there, they whisked me into the dressing room and then put me into hair and makeup and then pushed me onto the stage, you know, and we were click, click, click. It was really fast.
Well, now, we were told that yeah. one of the reasons that you were chosen for this ad with all these other ladies is that you are not, or you don't feel that you are sort of typecast by what you do for a living, by your profession, by mm-hmm. your age, by your size, and mm-hmm. all of these women feel that way, and that's why they were chosen. So does that fit you? You feel like you can do anything, and you're not put in a little box?
I'd try anything. Pretty much any, well, kind of, almost anything.
You don't start over.
If they were providing lunch, yes, I'd be there.
Well, you do so many wonderful things, and people love to give you awards. I know one of the recent things that happened, it was this past Friday, and we have a video of this,
uh-huh.
of the Hollywood Walk of Fame. You
yeah,
got a star. Look at this.
That's neat.
Now,
that is
really a big deal, so mm-hmm. I can't imagine the emotions going through your mind when that was unveiled like that.
Well, it was very exciting. I was thrilled to pieces, and at first I thought, well, a star, well, there's so many there, you know, I didn't know what the significance of it really was, and then they said, well, only a few are picked each year.
Right.
And I thought, well, wow, that's really neat. And when I got there, there was just so many fans, and a lot of them I recognized from coming to my shows.
Right.
I was just really thrilled they all showed up.
That's good. Now it's important to know, in front of what store?
Yeah, where are
and
you?
And who's on the other side?
Well, if you were in front of the Chinese Theater, walk left.
Okay.
And I'm down there, and I'm right beside Meryl Streep.
Ooh.
Yeah, I thought that was pretty good.
Meryl Streep says, no, I'm next to Reba McEntire.
That's
pretty strong. That's neat.
And we went to her premiere the other night of her new movie. It was very, very good. And, of course, I'm promoting the new movie that's mine coming out on CBS on Sunday night.
Mm-hmm.
So I was walking down the red carpet. I was doing every interview. And I was doing one, and I was sitting there talking very, very nice. And pretty somebody come up behind me and put their arm around me. I'm like, oh, good. Hi, and it was Meryl Streep.
Really?
It was.
Yeah.
Had you met her before?
No, I'd never met her before. But you know, in 1991, when I sang that song on the Oscars,
yeah,
she was supposed to sing, I'm checking out of this Heartbreak Hotel. And I sang it for her, and she walked up and she said, Reba, I never did get to thank you for taking my place that night. And the lady said, well, why didn't you sing? And she says, because I was 175 pounds pregnant, that's why.
Be honest about it, you know.
So I'm going to write her a letter and let her know the rest of the story, what all happened with the plane crash and why I almost didn't go. And I think that would really mean a lot to her.
Well, she was aware of all that, don't you think? She was aware of all that?
Probably not. 175 pounds pregnant, that's all you were thinking about.
Well, I guess so.
Having that baby, I'm sure.
That's
but she's a very devoted mother and a very beautiful person. I just sat and stared at her. She's just so pretty.
She's that's just good. About my favorite actress.
Yeah.
She's just you.
Well, we're going to talk
$20.
About the... we're going to talk about the movie here in a few minutes. But first of all, Wednesday night, the awards. You're up for an award with Brooks and Dunn.
Yes.
And these guys...
How are you going to ask this? I guess you are.
What?
Fine, go ahead.
What about
go ahead.
Where Kix is singing and sometimes he accidentally... Spits.
Is
it going to be a problem? I mean, when the two of you are singing that song, right?
No, I've just let him spit in my face one time, and that was it.
That was it?
And the next day, he came out with this yellow rain slicker for me. And he
while you're singing the song?
He put it in my dressing room the next night. We were singing Cotton Fields, and he went, when I was, and some words, he was just, you know, and we got through that night. I said, would you quit spitting in my face? And so the next night we got to the show and there was this big yellow rain slicker in my dressing room. And I told Sandy, now whenever they go around that way and I come around right before Cotton Fields, get it to me. And I put it on everything. He like to lost it. It was hysterical.
I bet.
Well, now what's your trick to keep from spitting when you sing?
I swallow. Swallows, but anyway.
You know, this just proves when you ask a dumb question. Well, not often is this lady speechless. In June, we saw you speechless. Can we roll the tape? When George Lindsay was up on stage at the TNN Music City News Country Awards and announced that you were winning the Minnie Pearl Humanitarian Award, I can't believe they kept it from you, but as the camera goes to you, it was so obvious.
Who did I look to first?
Narvel, why didn't you tell me?
Hey. He was the one that kept it from me. He's so good at that. He didn't tell anybody.
Were you sort of mad at him that he didn't tell you?
No, I was just so shocked. No, see, we were sitting there, and nobody showed up to the left of me, and Narvel's to the right of me, and I looked over, and there's Vince sitting over there. Hey, Vince, come here. Keep me company. Let's visit. So we were sitting there visiting, and Goober got up, and he was up there, and we all love Goober.
Yeah.
And so he was up there, he was talking, and the guy came with the camera right in front of Vince. I said, well, that's great. Vince is going to win. I forgot. Vince had already won it. He wins so many awards, I forgot.
Right.
So I was just sitting there, well, Vince is going to get it. And pretty soon Goober said, and I say a lady, because this year, and the camera went right over to me, and I'm getting these chills again.
Mm-hmm.
It just went all over me. I'm like, I'm getting this award. And right. Vince looked down at me and he said, this is the one that really means something. You're getting this because you're a good person, not because you can sing.
Well,
it's a special lady.
It's probably going to be another magical night for a lot of people on Wednesday. We'll be watching. But also Sunday, another magical night for you. A new movie. We have a little preview of Reba's TV movie right after this. Don't go away.
What is this really about? Because it doesn't feel like it's about Emma.
Of course it's about Emma.
Well, what makes you think she doesn't love him?
Because I look in her eyes.
Oh, Lizzie, come on. That is silly.
Don't baby me. That's all you've done ever since I woke up. I can get upset. I can live my own life. I can even make love, Alex. I'm not gonna break.
At 9 Eastern, 8 Central. Tell us a little bit about the story and what's going on with Lizzie.
It's based on a true story. This woman, she's very madly in love with her husband, has a beautiful 2-year-old daughter, and they're out on the playground, and the character I play is swinging my little daughter, and she has a stroke, and so she goes into this coma. And so after she wakes up, she deals with all the things that has been going over the last 20 years.
20
coma
years?
For 20 years.
Yeah, the lady that this story is kind of based on was in a coma for 30 years. And her husband took care of her all 30. Those 30 years.
Did you meet her?
No, I met her daughter, Marilyn.
Yeah.
And talked to her about it.
What kind of research do you put into a role like this? Because you're dealing with so many human emotions, and there are going to be some life lessons learned in this, probably.
Well, the thing that really hit me so hard was, what would I do if I woke up one day and Narva looked a little different and I said, well, where's Shelby? He said, well, Shelby's in college now.
Right.
Shelby's married and got three kids. What would you do? Mm. All the years you missed. And so that my heart ached for Lizzie all the time because she missed Emma growing up. Everything changed. And, you know, there was microwaves, there was frozen yogurt, there was, you know, shot by mail on television. There was stuff that she had no idea what was going on about. And so she had to catch up in days what everybody else had 20 years to go through.
You know, I know you're real picky in what you do with your career. Why did you want to do this script?
I thought it was very heartfelt, very emotional. And I got to work with Tim Matheson and Bess Armstrong, two wonderful actors. And now we're all good buddies, good friends. And that's the best thing to bring out of any project, our friends.
Well, you know, when you have a story this powerful, it's a test on your acting ability, too.
Mm-hmm.
How you feel?
I think I improved from the last movie. Lord knows I needed to.
No, it takes a good script will do that. It will improve an actress. And,
and
we have another clip here, and I believe this is where there's a confrontation about, I guess, an affair involving your husband or something.
Yeah.
You want to set it up?
Yeah, my best friend, who we were just inseparable before, and just the greatest of friends. And when I wake up, I find that she's been a little bit more than a good friend. She's been helping raise my child and take care of my husband.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
What's
take a
this?
Look.
I don't know many men who would have done what he did for as long as he did it.
You're in love with him. Why didn't you just tell me? Why didn't you just tell me? Well, I made Bess cry, and I didn't like that.
Well, I can't imagine where the storyline goes. I mean, when you walked away from finishing the movie, and I guess when people watch this movie, when it's over, how are we going to feel?
I think you're going to go hug your kids. You're going to go... This was a very strong, another strong lesson point for me by saying, don't take today for granted.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure you live every day as if it's your last. And go tell the people that you love them. Go hug your kids. Go hug your husband's neck and say, baby, I love you.
Well, speaking of kids and husband, how does Narva and how does Shelby feel about your acting? I mean, kids are honest. Mm-hmm. They tell you what they think.
Shelby watched it one time. Mm-hmm. And I said, Shelby, Granny and Papaw's here. They want to watch the movie. You want to watch the movie with them? Oh, that's too sad. I don't like to see you cry.
Really?
Oh, he just bawls when I cry. He can't stand it.
Well, I mean, this is good because that means it was very believable for him.
Yeah, but the first time when I wake up and I see my daughter for the first time, that's to me the most heart-wrenching part of the... Oh. It just chokes me up to talk about it. Oh. It's the most heart-wrenching part of the whole movie, and Shelby lost it.
Really?
He crawled up in my lap. He said, Mom, I don't like to see you cry.
Oh, so you're going to make me cry.
Yeah. Well, see, I mean, this is a very emotional... But let's make somebody happy. Will you help us make somebody...
Sure,
roll us
sure.
in, Bob. This is our Viewer Club box, which contains all our Viewer Club members in there. And we thought, since you were here, if you didn't mind,
not
we would impose on you to personalize a T-shirt of yours.
Right. Should I dig in?
Yeah, go right
Should
ahead.
Should I dig in? Well, now, Reba, while you're doing that, I have a question for you.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I guess it's on Tuesday night, the big premiere is here in Nashville, of your movie.
Yeah,
And you're going to be sitting in that theater with everybody, your friends and your peers, and you're going to hear them react or not react. Is this just the worst part of the whole thing for you? Okay.
Exactly. I may be in the bathroom a lot.
I was going to ask if you're even going.
I got to show up. I think.
Okay, the winner of the autographed... Reba McEntire.
And the pen if you want it.
And the pen if you want it that she actually touched.
She'll autograph
and maybe she cried on it. From Denver, Colorado, Nance Egan.
Good.
Nance.
Hello, Nance.
Hey, autograph that to Nance, would you?
Yeah, sure.
In the meantime,
Wednesday night on CBS at the award show, Forever Love will be performed by Reba McEntire, top 10 hit, and Forever Love, the movie, Sunday night at 9 o'clock Eastern. Check it out from the lovely and talented Reba McEntire.
If you see him, the hot album from Reba, go get it.
Straight ahead, Southern Gospel Quartet, the Kingdom.